everyone, it's Rachel back again with another reaction video. Today I will be reacting to a new song from Wage War. It's called Surrounded, and it is a B-side off of the album Blueprints, which I really enjoy that album. It was fantastic. For me, Wage War, I really enjoy them, like a lot of other people. I didn't enjoy Pressure too much, other than seeing it live when I went to the Pressure tour last year. The songs were much better live than they sit with me, repeat value-wise, listening to the album itself. Other than Low, I thought when Low came out as a single, it was an absolute banger. I still love that song and go back to it, but a lot of the songs just didn't really sit with me long-term off that album. I didn't think it was terrible or trash or anything, but I think given the rest of their discography and the other stuff that they've put out that I enjoy, it just wasn't quite up to par for me. So I am stoked to see this as a B-side off of Blueprints because that album was sweet. It's probably my favorite other than Deadweight. I'm not sure, but I'm stoked to check this out. I am going to stop talking and we're going to get straight into it. The guitar that just kicked in right there. Wage War, Surrounded, let's discuss. This is definitely a solid song, although I don't think that it quite lives up to the rest of the original album, that this is written with. I think that it's rightfully a B-side track. It feels rightfully a B-side track when you take it and compare it to the actual album. You've got songs like 21, Young Blood, The River. I really could go on with that list too, and I think that that says something. All off of the original album, all very awesome songs. Some of the songs that really got me into Wage War when I got into them. So there were just a few parts of this song that I thought it might deliver more than it actually did, or it kind of just fell off on certain parts where I thought it would maybe get a little bit heavier. A few different things like that. But regardless of that, we're going to look at this track as its own entity. It definitely has that powerful riff type Wage War that we get with this album, something I love to hear. I don't think that we see that very much or as much on their newer material with Pressure. Although there are parts of Low and I think maybe a couple of other songs where it's present. Overall on the album, nowhere near their past releases. But with this song, it's definitely something that you get. I think that the overall tone of the song balanced really well with the drumming, which might sound weird, but just pretty consistently throughout this song, it's something that I was noticing. The strings and the drumming sounded really nice together. So the way that that was working out, I enjoyed. I think that the chorus was solid. It was kind of all right, but I think if you go and listen to the chorus off of Low and you compare the two, Low off of Pressure, I think that Low has a much better chorus, and then that potentially still shows progression while their newer album may not be my cup of tea. I really loved the chorus on Low, whereas this song, it felt like a good chorus. I didn't feel like I heard it and was like, this sucks or anything like that. It just did not grab me the same way that that chorus off of Low did. And I think there are even a few other songs off of Pressure after seeing them live that had that same effect on me. Don't know why that was so hard to say, but with this one I feel like it could have used a little bit something more in that chorus, although clean vocals sounded amazing per usual. Love the clean vocals that we get on Wage War. So even though I still enjoyed the chorus, there's just something about that Low type of chorus where it grabs you and it's different and it sounds very good. I don't think that that's something that you see on this song. So I think that I guess I've really said enough about that. So that little breakdown after, I think it said, "We are not the same." It had a pause at the end of it that definitely tricked me. I thought the song was just going to end right there, but I should know better after all of the music that I've listened to that does that. It still got me, though. And then after that, you get a little breakdown, but I felt like that could have been maybe beefed up a little bit more, or after that, you get the chorus again, and then you get, like, some drumming indicating that something's gonna happen, and you get some, like, panic chord-type guitar after that, which sounded cool, but I think both of those parts maybe could have, like, been combined to hit with something more powerful or something like that, especially when you get that style of drumming that indicates something's about to happen, and then it's just kind of like a little bit of a all right, that wasn't anything too crazy. But again, I liked that like panic chord sounding guitar part. And then you also get at the last vocal piece that you have, there is one vocal line that says "forgives." I think it's the very last vocal line on the entirety of the song. And the first time it's said, the word "forgives," the vocal note there, very awesome, sounded amazing. I went back and listened to it again a second time after the song ended. So I really like that. I'm glad that Wage War decided to release this. This is off some of my favorite Wage War era. So I enjoyed that. Overall, I'd call this a good song. It'll definitely be something that I'm able to listen to again, that I put on a few of my playlists, but nothing that really was out of this world for me. It was all right, so I'm a fan. I'll listen to it again. Not wowed, but still very glad it was released. I do love Wage War, so let me know what you thought in the comments, and if you have a different song that you would like to be added to either of the lists that I work off of when I'm doing request-based videos. I'll put both links in the description as well as the invite link for the Discord server. We have a lot of interesting conversation going on in there. We've had new people joining left and right. So if you're interested in coming to join and hang out, the link will be in the description. And lastly, if you are enjoying the style of music, content, bands that I post on my YouTube channel, I post more music-related content on my Instagram. My handle is Rachel Reacts. I will put it up here on the screen for you. And of course, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it.